The Lazy Donkey. Once upon a time, there lived a trader in a small village. He traded different items in the market for money. The trader had a donkey. He used to put sacks of goods on the donkey's back and take them to the market to sell. The trader took really good care of his donkey. He knew that the donkey was important for his business. The donkey was kept clean and healthy. He was given good food to eat. He was young and strong. He could take the load of many sacks on his back and walk to the market. But he was also very lazy. The donkey didn't like to work at all. He only wanted to sit around, eat, and sleep.
Oh, to the market again. Master should take a day off someday. I love holidays. Maybe he does not need rest, but I do.
But the donkey did not understand that the trader could not take a holiday. If the trader does not go to the market, then he will not earn. And then there will be no food, even for the donkey. Depending on the demand in the market, the trader used to sell different things every day. Pulses, grains, vegetables, spices, and even fruits. He used to walk his donkey every day from his village. Each day to reach the market, they had to cross a river. The trader took special care of the donkey while crossing the river. One day, a friend told the trader that there is a heavy demand for salt in the market.
Thank you for the tip, my friend. I must start selling salt soon.
Soon, the trader arranged for 12 sacks of salt to be sold. He took 6 sacks and started to load them on the donkey's back. He then realized that the sacks were getting heavy. The donkey could not walk.
Oh, poor animal. It must be getting too heavy for him. There, I will take a sack off. This should do.
Not wanting to hurt the donkey, the trader lifted 1 sack off his back. However, even then the donkey was not ready to walk. The trader cared for his donkey, but he also knew that the donkey was lazy. He took out a stick and poked him.
Oh, come on now, don't be so lazy. You have rested enough. We need to go to the market.
That day, the trader sold all the sacks of salt in the market.
Oh, my friend was right. The demand for salt is increasing now.
The trader then started to sell salt every day. He used to fill sacks and sacks of salt and load them up on the donkey. The donkey had to carry sometimes 5 and sometimes 6 sacks to the market. Though not happy, the donkey was always relieved while returning home. Since the trader sold all the sacks of salt, he had no load to carry back. A few days passed. Then one day, the trader loaded 6 sacks of salt and left for the market. As they reached the river, the trader noticed that the water was a little bit high.
Let's walk very slowly today. I don't want to slip and fall into this gushing water.
As they crossed half the river, suddenly the donkey slipped off a big stone and sat down with a thud.
Oh no! Oh!
The trader somehow managed to pull the donkey up and made him cross the river. The donkey was scared and shocked, but then he felt something.
Didn't you? The sacks are still on my back. Then, how does my back feel so light? Oh, this river has magical powers. Didn't you? Didn't you?
What the donkey didn't know is that there was no magic in the river, When he fell, the water dissolved all the salt in the sacks, which is why the donkey felt no load on his back. There was no salt left in the sacks now.
Oh, all my effort is gone. What do I sell now? Thank God that my donkey isn't hurt. There is no point in going to the market now. I should just go home.
What? No load on the back and no work? This truly is magic. Didn't you?
After cutting his trip short, the donkey had the entire day to himself. He ate and slept all day. He was happy. The next day, the trader again loaded 6 sacks of salt on the donkey's back and walked him to the market.
Oh, yesterday was so nice. Today, again, I have to work. Wait, I can avoid working. I can lessen the burden on my back and go back home, just like yesterday. The water has magical powers. I am sure it will help me again.
Unaware of the donkey's intentions, the trader started walking towards the market. As they reached the river, the donkey went a step ahead. And before the trader could stop him, he sat down in the same spot he had fallen.
Oh, what are you doing, you fool? Get up!
But it was too late. The salt kept on the donkey's back had dissolved in the water again. There was no burden. The donkey was now happy.
There it is. No burden and no work.
How did this happen? Wait a minute. Did this donkey sit down in the river on purpose? Oh, what a lazy animal. I care for him so much. And this is how he pays me? Let me take him home. I know what I have to do now.
The donkey thought that he had found a perfect way to avoid work, but the trader had a different plan. The next morning, the trader loaded 8 sacks on the donkey's back, but the donkey did not complain.
Oh, 8 sacks? But why can't I feel the burden? Why does it matter? Let Master put as many sacks on my back as he wants. I am not going to the market anyway, didn't you?
The trader silently walked the donkey to the river.
Ah, there is my magic.
While crossing the river, the donkey slipped again at the same spot and sat down in the water. However, today the trader did not pick his donkey up. As the donkey tried to get up, suddenly...
Oh no! My back! What is happening? Why is my back so heavy? Didn't you?
The trader was an intelligent man. He knew that the donkey would try to trick him again. So this time, instead of loading salt on the donkey's back, he loaded cotton. As soon as the donkey sat in the water, cotton absorbed the water and became heavier.
You thought you could fool me? Now you will have to walk to the market and come back home with these 8 sacks.
Oh no, didn't you? This is so heavy. My back.
The donkey realized that the water was not magic after all. He carried the 8 heavy sacks of cotton to the market and then back home. From that day onwards, the donkey never dared to sit in the water again.